Hello students, welcome to the next video in Module 5. The topic which we are going to discuss in this module are using the delegation event model and adapter classes. So in this video, we are going to discuss about the importance of and some of the examples of event handling mechanisms in delegation model. So in the delegated way of handling the events, how this even listeners and even sources are making a big role in the handling of event is the today's topic, and adapter classes is another one topic which we are going to discuss today. Let us go to the topic. The delegation event model is performed in a quite easy way. What are the two steps followed in the delegation model? Means first one is implementing the appropriate interfaces in the listeners. So what is the exact operation or task we are going to perform in the event? So the corresponding event listeners should be implemented in a correct way. And then what is the recipients for the event? So who is the recipient? So that should be registered or either unregistered. So these two, registering and unregistering, is the next step for handling the event in the delegation model. So here this delegation model is going to be explained with the two important events. First one is the mouse event. So we know that mouse event is a very biggest important one, as we are playing a major work in you with the help of mouse. Thus this mouse handling is a very important major event. So with this we are going to see one example program. Here the applet is combined, so we are going to perform all the mouse events with the help of applet. So what is the step for creating an applet? Means before going for a class, we have to create the applet code. So what is the applet code? Means it starts with the keyword applet. Code is nothing but the class of the event, name of the class, and width is nothing but the width of that applet window and height of the applet window. Then we are closing the applet. So this is the coding for applet. Then we can move on to the class. This class is going to be extends the applet and implements two important listeners. What are the listeners? Means mouse listener and mouse motion listener. As we know that we are going to perform the mouse handling operation in the applet, so that class should extends the applet class and implements the corresponding interfaces of mouse listener and mouse motion listener. Then we are going for a one message, empty message. As of initial condition, the x coordinate and y coordinates are termed as zero. Then in the init of that applet, we are going to add the mouse listener and mouse motion listener of that applet container. So that's what this keyword is used. Then we are going to perform one by one. When the mouse is clicked, what happened? Means we have to send a message as mouse clicked with the corresponding x and y values. X will be 0 and y will be 10. Like that, it should be that corresponding message should be typed over there. So to typing that over, we need to paint that applet. So that's what repaint method is called. And whenever the mouse is entered, we need to send a message as mouse entered. That should be repainted again. Then similarly, mouse exited also, we need to be notified with the message of mouse exited. Then mouse released means when at yet exact what coordinate that mouse is going to be released. That coordinate should be mentioned. The corresponding message up message should be performed. Similarly, mouse is dragged. Whenever the mouse is dragging, we need to display a message like star. That means we need to paint over that mouse. Say for example, I'm moving like this. So I'm going to draw one diagram. Means I'm just moving. Whenever I'm moving, that star character should be painted. So this is what mouse dragging and mouse moved. So it will show the status of corresponding x and y coordinator and then paint. What is happening in paint? Means whenever the repaint is calling, at that time the corresponding message with the x and y coordinators will be drawn. So here this is one example program output. So this is created with the applet of 300 width and 400 height, and this shows the applet, and mouse is moving at the position of 146 comma 51. That mouse moving position. So when the mouse is now pressed. So pressed in the sense that it will show the down message. So likewise, the output is given. Then we move on to the next event called as event, keyboard event. Keyboard event also here it is performed with the help of applet. So the applet is created with a simple key with a width of 300 and 100 in height. Now we can move on to the class. So this class is going to be extends the applet and implements the key listener. Only one listener is going to be performed here. Then initially the string and x and y coordinators are n and y, and initially it is empty. So whenever the applet is going to be initiated, it is added with the key listener. Then what is the method performed in key listener means key pressed. So whenever the key is pressed, if I am going to press one key here, means it will show the status as key down. So this is the one applet output. So here when I'm pressing the key, it shows the keys down, and when a key is released, it will show the key up. And whenever the key event is typed, means typing in the sense, at that time it will show one message. So I can show some, this is the test like that, I can show some text images. At that time, the key will be in the up position. So this corresponding messages is are painted in the paint method using the graphics class. So this is the output of key event. Right, I hope so this mouse event and key event is understandable to you. Then we can move on to the next important concept called as adapter classes. Java provides a special feature called as adapter classes that will simplify the creation of event handler in some of the particular situation. For example, mouse motion adapter is one of the adapter class. It will have two methods. What are the two methods? Means mouse dragged method and mouse moved method. So this will exactly defines the concept of mouse motion listener. So this adapter is performing many of major of the operations of mouse motion listener. So by using the by overriding the methods of mouse dragged and mouse moved, I can perform the mouse event in a most quick and easier way. So these, likewise, these are all the some of the adapter classes which are defined in the method package called as java.aw.event. So component adapter, container adapter, focus adapter, key adapter, mouse motion adapter, window adapter. So these are the different adapter classes which are combined with, which are mapped with its corresponding listener. So component adapter is having component listener, container adapter is having container listener, focus adapter is having focus about listener. We will go for one example program. This is also performed with the applet code. Here adapter demo is the class name which extends the adapter. So in the initial of that applet class, we are going to add the two listeners called as mouse listener and mouse motion listener. Whenever you are adding the mouse listener, what we will do, we will only call the event classes. Now here we are calling the adapter classes of this applet. So this is the new differences between the adapter classes. Instead of calling the event classes, we are calling the adapter classes. So for mouse listener, mouse adapter. For mouse motion listener, mouse motion adapter is the one of the adapter class. So likewise, we are calling, and it extends the mouse adapter. Here, for the adapter demo class, we are creating one object adapter demo. Using the adapter demo, that corresponding applet is assigned to a mouse adapter class. So what will happen means whenever the mouse is clicked, it will show the status. It will show the status. So what kind of the status means, whether the mouse is clicked, moved, and then it is unclicked, it is moving in this particular location. Likewise, it will show all the status of these corresponding methods. So mouse dragged means it will show the mouse dragged message. So similarly, it will show all the status of this corresponding mouse motion. So I hope so this video is understandable for you. I will catch you in the next video about next topic. Thank you.